Hello, today we are going to make a sculpture of hand. We use our hands to create and to make things. Also we use it to express ourselves. Look at your hand. You can fix it in so many different positions. We can make it open palm or fist, like sign, pointy finger, and so on. Hand signs have different meanings in different cultures. For this instruction, I decide to make one that I believe have pretty much the same meaning across the board. It could mean English letter V. It represents bunny in funny ways. Upside down it would represent walking man. And of course it is international sign of peace. Art for peace. Let's make it. Inflate a balloon, color of your choice. I use yellow or gold color in this instruction, leaving about 3-inch flat tail. I use only 260s balloons in all my instructions, so the hand is gonna be oversized. Let's twist the first about 7-8-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. The first bubble represents the ring finger. Twist the second soft about 1-inch bubble. The third bubble we're going to make to represent the little pinky finger. Twist the third soft about 6-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. I forgot to mention, I'm making the sculpture of right hand. This is going to be the front side. Now let's bend the balloon to measure the size of the fourth bubble. The fourth bubble represents the fleshy part, the base of thumb. Let's twist the fourth soft, about 6-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first four bubbles in one lock twist. The next fifth bubble we make to represent thumb. But first, we have to force the rest of the balloon halfway through the loop of the first bubble and then through the loop of the third bubble. Our hands and fingers come in different shapes and size, so you may want to change size of bubbles for this sculpture. Here we didn't make the fifth bubble yet, but we already have the loop of the fifth bubble. Let's force the fourth bubble halfway through the loop of the future fifth bubble. Here's the back view, here's the front view. And this is the bottom view. Now let's pull the rest of the balloon through the loops to tighten up the loop of the fifth bubble. Okay. So now we're going to twist the fifth bubble. The size is, well, it's hard to say. You know, let's take another look on our sculpture. The side view, the back view, the bottom view, and here's the front view. We're making the sign peace. That's a hand sign. So now let's twist the fifth soft about 7-inch bubble. Actually, it's quite hard to measure the size of the fifth bubble, but it should protrude up to 1 inch through the loop of the third bubble. That it would be the size of it. So again, here we are. Twist the fifth soft bubble. Now we can lock the free end of the fifth bubble by forcing it between the third bubble and the second or third and the fourth bubble. Our next step actually depends on the size of the rest of the balloon. We can use the rest of the balloon to represent either middle or the index finger. I'm going to twist the sixth soft about 1-inch bubble. Instead of small sixth bubble, we can make flat space. And now I'm going to roll the sixth bubble around the second bubble. This way we lock the ends of the sixth bubble with appropriate ends of the second bubble. If you made the flat space instead of the sixth small bubble, you have to do basically the same thing to bring the rest of the balloon on the backside of the hand. Make sure to lock the bubbles properly. You don't want them untwist. Taking this point, it makes sense to roll bubbles around each other a couple times, not just once, as I did in this example. And here's a back view, that's a front view. Now let's take the rest of the balloon and bring it on the back side of the sculpture, fix it between bubbles. We force the rest of the balloon between the first and the fourth bubble. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. That's it. So far we have made the sculpture with four fingers. And we already can use it as it is, because many cartoon characters especially have only four fingers. Easy to make, right? Well, we want to make our sculpture with five fingers, and that's where we're going to use the second balloon. Normally we inflate and twist balloons from the nozzle. In this example, we're going to do it from the upper side end of the balloon. Stretch couple times the very tip of the balloon. Inflate the balloon slightly. Make sure the air goes to the very end of the balloon. If necessary, force the air to the very end of the balloon. Inflate the rest of the balloon as much as you want. In this example, actually, about 10 inch long bubble will do. I inflated it more than that. So again, we're going to use this balloon to twist just one bubble to represent either middle or index finger. So looking from the back side of the sculpture, let's measure the size of the bubble. This sculpture is a replica of my hand, and my index finger is shorter than my middle finger. And so I'm making slightly different size bubbles. One is about 1 inch shorter than another one. Lock the free end of the first bubble of the second balloon at the base of the last bubble of the first balloon. Force these two bubbles from the back side of the hand between bubbles of the first balloon. We can use the rest of the balloon to represent the arm. It looks like we already have made the hand in the shape of a sign of peace. Alright, let's just fix all bubbles in proper positions. Working the sculpture in the same fashion, we can make the hand in different shapes, representing different signs. In this example, we made two extended fingers, the middle finger and the index finger. If you lock both ends of one of those fingers, you'll get a different sign, hand sign. With one only extending finger, for example, index finger, it could be hand sign to point direction or to point on something. And of course, extended middle finger, it's another international sign. No adults need explanation about that. Alright, kiddos, I'm going to skip this part. So we can use the sculpture as it is. We can attach it to hat, simple trifold hat will do. We can fix the hand on the arm in a different positions, pointing up or sideways. Here I made the hand pointing up. Now I'm going to cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. Given the size of this hand, we still can use it with small sculptures of cartoon characters. Many cartoon characters have big hands and very small or thin arms, which makes it really funny. Again, here we made the peace sign or bunny or English letter V. The next part of the video I'm going to fast play. I want to go quickly over the arms. We can use different color balloon to make the arms. We can use one balloon to make the arm, or we can use two or more balloons to make arm. In this example, I lock nozzle of the first blue balloon with the first yellow bubble, and the nozzle of the second blue balloon I lock with the third yellow bubble. Here's the backside. Let's work the first blue balloon. Twist the first about 1 inch bubble. Twist the second about 2 inch bubble. Lock the free end of the second blue bubble with the nozzle of the second blue balloon. And the rest of the sculpture we work well in the same fashion as in previously published instruction, Fabric 8. I'm not going to waste your time explaining the same matters again and again. So working in this fashion, we can make the arm as big as we want, as long as we want. And again, in this example, I'm using two balloons to make the arm. We can use more than two, for example, three or four balloons to make the arm. Then the arm will be hollow inside, kind of a sleeve, and it makes it very interesting. Because the person would be able to put his arm inside of the sculpture. It makes it wearable as a costume. Making costumes, it's a separate topic beyond scope of this instruction, obviously, but this sculpture could be good part of the costume. All right, I think it is enough for this instruction about the arms, how to make the arm in one of the simplest forms. Now let's take a final look on the sculpture. Here I forgot to hide the end of the balloon. We can trim it with scissors, or just hide it between bubbles of the hand. Now I have to fix the bubbles in proper positions again. All right, that's our hand, this arm, partial arm. And here's another example. I used different color balloon to make the hand, and I left it on one balloon arm. Here's a back view. And here's another example of two balloons arm. I made the arm long up to the elbow. Here's the side view and the front view. This hand sign has different meanings. The one I like, art for peace. Have fun and happy twisting.